You're a seahorse. You probably aren't, but work with me here. You were just born into a litter of about 1,000 other seahorse brothers and sisters. Most of them are now your deceased brothers and sisters, considering only 0.5% of you will survive. And that's okay, because you'll never meet them, or your parents for that matter. So now you're in the big oceanic abyss alone. Which next move? Well, you gotta eat. And considering you literally don't have a stomach or greater digestive system, food goes through you really fast. So you gotta eat a lot. About 30 to 50 times a day, to be exact. So, what are you going to eat? Well, mostly small crustaceans and other invertebrates. Delicious. So you better start poking your tube-shaped snout into those little rock nooks to get them right where they live. And luckily for you, you have a hunting success rate of 95%, more than even great white sharks. So now, you have a life and food. You just got to do that for about 4 months until you can fulfill your life's purpose, making a comically large amount of other seahorses. Now, this next step changes depending on if you're male or female. For the sake of example, you're going to be male today. Happy birthday. Now, you just got to find some hot local seahorse babes in your area. Congratulations, one took pity on you, and you were seahorse face, and is ready to procreate with you. You guys make a heart shape, it's adorable, there was just one unexpected item in the bagging area. You're going to be the one getting pregnant. Consider it a birthday present. And, double surprise, your hot local seahorse babe has abandoned you, just like your parents did. She has to stick it in as many other seahorses as possible. Use it before you lose it kind of attitude. Now you gotta get back to your riveting life of hunting food and trying not to get eaten by one of the many things that wants to eat you. Hopefully, you're even more passionate about life now because you have a family, dammit. Flash forward 26 days and congrats, it's time to give birth. You eject up to 1,000 seahorse babies and most of them will die, but you don't care. Because just like your parents before you, you're abandoning those kids. Your baby mama daddy is out there somewhere, and those 1,000 kids mean fat child support stacks. Who cares how many of them survived? But in your conquest for your long-lost one-night stand, you're eaten. Now exactly what you've been eaten by is up to you. Could be a small shark, a stingray, or literally any fish that's bigger than you are. Which concludes your short seahorse life.